so I already had these slabs from a while back. I actually don't know what kind of wood it is. So if you actually, when you see them, if you know what it is, please do let me know in the comment section, because I've been breaking my head wondering what this wood is. So to join these two slabs together, I actually am very excited to use for the very first time my Craig pocket hole jig. So I'm excited to see how, like, you know, how easy it is to use. I've seen videos that it's pretty easy, so I'm actually not very concerned, but I'm excited about it though. Okay, now, so the top is ready, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the sides to be more square. I'm just gonna take the front and square the sides to it. All right, so I finally have this joined and kind of covered the seam already. It's not the best job, but that's how I'm gonna leave it for now. I'm sure you can do a better job if you actually had wood filler. Since I don't have wood filler, had to use glue with sawdust. It looks pretty smooth and it looks all right. So I'm gonna leave it that way, and I'm gonna move to the next step, which is making the legs at the height that my wife wants it. So we're done cutting the legs now, so we're gonna measure and attach them to the top now. All right, so there's two things that I wanna do. First, I wanna do a small chamfer on the bottom edge of the tabletop. So these reinforcements on the side are gonna be in my way of the router. So I'm gonna remove one by one, do the chamfer, put it back on, and then do the same on the other side. And also we are gonna measure 1.25 inches from the edge before we do the chamfer, so that we have our measurement for the legs to go. All right, let's do that real quick. Alright then, the chamfer is done. I think it looks amazing. We're gonna do a roundover bit on the top edge of the table, but we'll do that after the legs are already installed and it's almost ready to go. So right now what we're gonna do, since we already have the measurements, we're gonna install the legs, and I think for that we're gonna use a combination of pocket holes and an L-shaped brackets, just to kind of like help me keep them in place. And also I think it'll give you a little more strength over time. So yeah, we'll do that now. So we have the legs already attached to the tabletop. I'm gonna add these L-shaped brackets, and you personally may not need this if you actually are making a table like this one, but I do, because this tabletop is actually very heavy, and I'm just a little bit concerned that the screws may come undone or come loose over time. So these L-shaped brackets are there to help give more strength to the table, but once again, you may not need to do this, so you can just skip this step. All right, so now that we have this, it's time to put the last piece before we give it another good sand and finish it. Stain it and finish it. Let's do it. so here we have it. It's already all done. All we need to do is put a round over this edge, stain it, and see what the wife thinks. Alright, so there it is. I think it came out looking really cool, and even though I know there's a lot of imperfections and I know that probably there's a lot that many of you would have done differently, I think it's still a pretty good job considering that I did this with only handheld tools. But if there's anything that you would have done differently, do let me know in the comment section, because I'm actually very interested to hear from you and to actually learn from you as well. How can I improve in my woodworking? If you like this video, I'd appreciate it if you clicked on that like button. And if you want to see more of this content, go ahead and subscribe and click the bell notification button so you don't miss on any future content. But this is it for now, guys. God bless you, and I'll see you next time.